Hello and welcome to another episode of Basic Stuff. Today the long-awaited How to Tank video for all the battleshippers around among us, or among this channel and whoever watches this video. Well, it's quite a thing. I will have several replays and I have kind of an order I'm proceeding through. First of all, what does tanking mean? Then important stuff you need to know before you enter the battle. And then I have 3 points while in game. Positioning, take breather, succeed by outlasting and killing. So that's the order I'm following. So I'm starting with the first topic, which would be, what does tanking mean? Well, tanking. You're the battleship. You're the ship class that has the most HP, the best armor, the most punchiest guns. That's your thing. So when I talk about tanking, I mean you need to be a sponge for your team when it comes to receive damage. That's your purpose, and not your only purpose, but one of your purposes. So not that your cruisers are tanking. Cruisers need to do damage over time to be effective. So if they are going out because you didn't present any target for the enemy cruisers, then they get focused down and die, or they are just not good. But that's not a factor you can't change. How do you tank correctly? Well, I see a lot of people saying, yeah, I tanked and then I died and blah 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 blah. There are certain factors which I come to later, but one of the most important, like for all the other ship classes, is positioning. Are you positioning yourself correctly? Are you committing yourself, or what? I mean, I see people that are exactly in that position I am, and they go turn now left and sit there, and then they have limited options because they are really bow on. Means they can't, or they are not easy to, or it's easy for them to get out of this situation, unless they are in a good situation to run away. So what I'm doing here, what I mostly do with the cruisers as well, especially when I see how many ships are on one side, and as you can clearly see, the A side is pretty heavily challenged by the enemy team. So I want to avoid being overextended and don't come out of this situation anymore. So I'm angling away. Montana is a good ship because, as you see, I can angle myself and shoot a lot of guns. But I come to this topic as well later. One thing you need to know as well is don't ever put out one fire. Only in situations where you know, okay, if I'm going dark afterwards because I'm concealed and nobody is shooting me afterwards, then you can put off one fire. Is there any danger of getting a consecutive fire? Don't do it. Let it last. You can use all your 5 heals. Good, really good games in a BB are normally when you used all your heals. That's practically what is the most important for in general what tanking makes or what tanking means. Of course, you want to be as angled as possible, and that's what I'm showing here. There's the Kurfürst I have to worry about, so I'm probably turning a bit my stern in, and I still can shoot a lot of targets down there. Alright, so that's generally what tanking means. Being a sponge for your team, receive damage, and so on and so on. Alright, so let's go over to the next point. Important stuff you need to know. Well, I talked about some important stuff already, or maybe general stuff, and maybe a lot of you know it already. Important stuff before the battle, sorry. Before the battle. You need to know your armor layout. Why is that? Well, let's take the Izumo for example. Izumo is pretty trollish and pretty good against AP Because it can angle good and the armor is really sufficient against a lot of calibers, from even from enemy battleships. On the other hand, it's really vulnerable to HE fire. So that depends what opposition you face. If you face an opposition with a heavy cruiser, with a lot of cruisers, then you don't want to be stationary at all, because you can't tank them over time. At least not as good as, for example, Montana Kurfürst or something else, or some other ships. So you want to avoid that. Also, a thing that you need to know is the gun angles. The Montana, for example, is a prime example of having really great gun angles. You can almost shoot his all of his 12 guns by just get a good angle, being angled, and bounce sufficient enough on mid to long ranges. So that's perfectly it. Alright, so I'm switching over to another replay, because that showed just basic stuff, what happens, and I mean, now I'm already dislodging, but I'm coming later to this. Alright, next replay, also Montana. Note that I'm only using replays of the high tiers, because the high tiers battleships are the ones that can really tank a lot and really good. So that's why I'm using mostly videos out of the higher tiers, but I'm also I can release a list of ships I recommend for tanking, and which I didn't recommend that much. But yeah, let's go on. This is replay is a prime example of being angled and also positioning. We are here on trap, and my purpose, or my goal, was to go into the egg area to get it and prevent the enemy of pushing it, for example, because as a battleship you're also a kind of a force that has to be reckoned with. You don't push in a cruiser just like brainless like into a battleship. You have some fear that you get deleted, right? That's why battleships are also a big factor when it comes to stop pushes and so on. And also, I wanted to add, because I just felt, since you are the sponge for your team, it allows your cruisers, if they aren't totally playing idiotic or something, to farm the damage and farm the enemy battleships, for example. But okay, let's go to the first of these really important points. I mean, that's the really important stuff we have, but the really important stuff, points are coming now. And as usual, it's positioning. And this game shows a prime example of how you position yourself wisely. You see, I don't overextend. I mean, we have A. I know what is coming. One cruiser, two battleships, three battleships. I think it's even four battleships. Let me quickly check. Ah, three battleships. So, yeah. Yamato, Montana, and another Montana here. So, I definitely don't want to sit here and tank Yamato, because he can overmatch my armor. You know? Now I know which ship can overmatch my armor. Yamato. So, you don't want to do that. And instead of shooting these battleships and this Montana, who are all fairly angled, I'm going to shoot everything what is up here. And you will see how I react when these guys are pushing even further. I mean, we have a Kagero, he can farm these guys. I have a Hindenburg behind me, who's also farming these guys. So there's literally nothing I can do unless I'm starting to shoot HE. That's the only thing. Due to lack of targets that I can shoot, because they are all hidden behind the island, I will shoot my next body, I think, on the Montana. But of course, I'm constantly... there is one on Des Moines. So I'm constantly trying to arrest the enemy cruisers, because that's your main purpose. Yeah, battleships are a danger to you, but only if they come really, really close. Unless you're staying angled. Especially Montana, Kurfürst, Yamato, you don't fear that much. Fear them that many. But the enemy Montana didn't get the... Didn't get the point. I mean, he is tanking, so to say, yeah? That's for sure. He is in an angled position. But instead of shooting me, he should shoot the Hindenburg here behind me. But he is not... I mean, I don't know if he's... No, he's definitely spotted. So why doesn't he shoot the Hindenburg? And you see these guys are proceeding. So I'm likely to end up in a crossfire. So positioning. Pretty important. I'm just taking this island to my left. And then I'm just sitting here and can still shoot all these guys up here. Reporting the target position. Right? So that's my plan. This Montana behind me is a prime example of how not to do it. I mean, okay, he's not panicking, he's reversing out of the situation, and he won't die that quickly to a Yamato as well, but still. He almost overcommitted. I had this place where I can still go this way, or turn away, maybe not concealed anymore. So I need to get rid of this guy to be concealed again. But I have no issues with cruisers, so this Hindenburg would be a really big pain in the ass, but I just brought this rock between me and him. So, one prime example of how to position yourself smart. Of course, I'm shooting now the Montana as well, because... that's, by the way, badly aimed. I'm aiming for his armor belt that won't... oh no, I aim for the superstructure. But normally I should shoot over there, but I constantly check if I can shoot, but this little island is just... yeah. Hindering me of landing any shots under the mines there. So I'm shooting the Montana, who is slowly reversing out of my concealment range. And since the Yamato died, I can play a bit more aggressive. So that's pretty much about positioning and smart positioning. Of course, I don't have to tank any HE damage on this game, but it shows how you can handle certain situations when you just use the characteristics of a map. Yeah, positioning, we come to another video, because it's just an important part, and I will talk about a bit and find different situations. Okay, since the ones still didn't show up, I even switched to HE, because he has damage gun, I think. So, yeah, but nevertheless, next replay. Alright, next replay here. So, this time Yamato. One of these stationary battleships, so-called. I mean, you also differentiate between stationary battleships and flexible battleships. For example, Montana is a flexible battleship, even though I stopped there and played like one quarter speed ahead, then reverse, and so on and so on. Still, it is flexible enough and has the concealment to get out of a lot of situations if needed. Alright, here we are on Two Brothers. I have a DD with me, and yeah. I bring myself in a position where it's easy for me to retreat. So I'm using my concealment value, which is 13.5. I don't want to be overextended. That's why I'm slowing down already there. I can go in a more offensive position later on, but I'm stopping here just because I don't know what's coming from here, right? So I need our DDs to spot something, and from there on I can estimate if I need to reverse or come closer. That's practically the same. I mean, if you see that you're... one of your other battleships is bleeding because of overextending or something, you maybe can do something by putting yourself into also a kind of difficult situation. But of course, most of the time you can't save them, because they just run into the enemy and die. And yeah, then it's like pointless to try to relieve him, because he's going to die anyway. So don't be such a team player that throws away his ship because your teammate is throwing away a ship. So always think rational about it. So, concealment range. I'm staying out of here. Of course, the DD will spot me, but that's why I have my own DDs. So far, there's nothing. So, no big HE firing threat, but still I'm reversing I don't know why exactly. I mean, I could go a bit forward. Now I'm spotted, so I can say that the DD is out of the smoke probably. And it's just passing this island somewhere here. That's, by the way, how you triangle for your DDs. I mean, on the other hand, he's just too far away, so that could also be that he ran out of my concealment range. That's kind of a good idea to do this. Of course, I'm shooting DD. There's nothing else I can shoot right now, so yeah. You see my Montana? He just ran into this fire of all of them. He overextended and now he's practically dead. I mean, he could turn in, but there's a Yamato. And what can he do, right? He's getting deleted. And he's not even stopping, he's just pushing. And that's what many people don't get, but... bad positioning, too aggressive in the start, and then you die really quickly. You need to use your HP efficient. Are there any differences between stationary and flexible battleships? That's a question. Yeah, in a stationary battleship you mostly cover an area. Especially, I mean, two process is a bad example because it's so separated, the map. But normally I try to cover two caps at once with my stationary battleships. Best thing is, of course, having some cover to hide behind in case it's gonna be a bit too stressful or you accidentally overextended or something. But always have a lookout for the enemy cruisers. I'm going to play a bit more aggressive since this Montana is overextending a lot and I want to punish him for it. This Montana is, by the way, doing it right. He didn't overcommit. And yeah, my DDs are a bit passive even though my teammate is running strange ways, I don't know, but okay. So, I can overmatch Montana if... Yeah, or I just wait until he's broadside on. Not sure if that will overmatch him. Well, just killed his gun, or not damaged his gun. But he brought himself in an absolutely horrible position. So there's one target I really don't like to see, that's the Hindenburg. Why is that? Well, the Hindenburg is one of these targets, or one of these ships, that are really a pain in the ass. I mean, I should have shot the Hindenburg instead. These Montanas can't do much to me when I'm angled, but they show too much broadside that I thought, okay, maybe I'm hitting Citadel two times and he's dead. But my aim and dispersion weren't the best. When it comes to aim, I know some of you might be a lot better, especially Masrul. It always shows me you have to be... you have to look at the armor meter and then... Yeah. Then you know what's going on and so on and so on. And you have... You know where to aim and so on. So, the Moin enters the room, also a Hindenburg. Yeah, that means for me I need to retreat a bit. This time I'm shooting the Moin, I guess. No, I'm not. But this is now coming to the next topic. Oh. Did I miss something here? What the hell? Okay, give me a sec. I need to. Yeah, well, let's do it without topic point. I don't know. Somehow my order here went wrong. The next point would be take a breather. Why take a breather? Yeah, you see what this HE spam means. So I'm retreating, and I try to get out of this situation really quickly. I just getting myself concealed, even with the fire. And of course I'm not putting it out. Yeah, you could also... I could have gone a bit out, more outside, but the Hindenburg turned away, so it's fine for me. I don't want to shoot. I wait for my fire get out, but now I'm spotted by some stupid plane, which is a bit unfortunate. And the Montana is coming again. He's doing exactly the same mistake again. But I can heal up. Going out full broadside again. Some people just won't understand. I mean, I couldn't punish him as he deserved to, but that's happening from while to while. Okay, since the cruisers are forced away or just ran away a bit more, I can maybe handle the Montana. But the gearing is already doing a good job. And this Montana is taking over the place for me, or my place of tanking damage. I'm not sure, he's a bit too... Nah, he stopped, okay, that's good. But I'm trying to be in one line, so we have two targets that are dangerous for the enemy cruisers, so maybe they split the fire. What they shouldn't do, they should focus down one target, that's for sure. And look at him, he's doing exactly the same. He can't damage me. Only one citadel, that's a bit sad, but yeah. I mean, do you have words for that? Alright, so... Honestly, I don't want to push. We are leading right now. So I'm waiting. I should at least wait. You see, even I am impatient sometimes. And I'm going too a bit aggressive. But I honestly try to relieve my... Montana a bit, but it's probably too late. Yeah, when it comes to take a breather, if the pressure gets too high, which is not the case here because this cruisers can't cap A at the moment since I am here, I'm not so pressured, but expect the enemy to push. Then you want to be in a position that you can reverse and reverse behind, heal up, maybe even reposition, and then go on tanking and shooting again. Because right now, it's just like I'm forcing the cruisers out. They try to find some suitable positions where they can farm me, which is totally fine. I can agree on that, but they have only the strange spotter plane there. And I don't know if that position of the Hindenburg was so smart, but okay. I just sent my DD over there to spot them, and then I'm fine. The moment I'm mostly spotted because of some stupid... yeah, here I'm even not spotted. The spotter plane was spotting me all the time, so I couldn't do much. By the way, this Hindenburg and Des Moines players are playing it really, really well. I have to admit that, and that's why it made it so difficult. So I'm just going on and on with the replay. You see, I'm already half HP. I only ate HE damage, which is all healable. So I'm still prepared for the late game. I have still sufficient HP left, and that's all that matters, right? You wanna come into the end game. Our Mogami did some questionable move through the middle there and brought us behind in points, which means we have to do something against it. And I hate this. I mean, people can't be patient. And yeah, especially in a battleship, you have to be patient most of the time. You have to be make your shots count. That's really important stuff. For example, I'm waiting here for broadsides. Sometimes you don't get the broadsides, and some of the cruisers will play it really smart and not show too much broadside. Especially that Des Moines played it quite well. He used he accelerated and sped up all the time. Especially on these long ranges, you have no chance against them if they know what they are doing. So yeah, I'm rather not shooting. I'm letting them come into my... until they spot me. I want to force them to come closer to me though. I have a better chance of hitting them. Attention. Okay, I think that's take a freezer in a nutshell. I mean, the general things are still counting. Don't put out one fire. I'm running most of the time survivability builds on my battleships. Yeah, put out the fire because I expect them. Look, they need like 3 kilometers to reach my concealment range. I'm still reversing, so it gives me some more time, and I'm only on one heal. So, and we are leading right now again, so there isn't actually no need. Okay, that guy is doing some. As I said, he's doing good stuff with reducing the speed, but doesn't help him because that guy. That volley. He didn't expect. I mean, probably Masru had something to complain about my aim, but as I said, I'm not Masru, I'm just a cruiser pleb normally, so. So hopefully I don't get a fire, can get unconcealed, and I'm fine. The enemy is realizing it, and both of these guys, at least the Hindenburg is trying to come closer. The Yamato tries to present a force as well, so not to end up with broadside on to the Yamato, I'm angling in a 45 degree to both of them. You don't want to have a full flat broadside for the Hindenburg as well, because if he starts shooting AP, you have a big, big issue. Alright, so Hindenburg. You think he would commit? That's the thing. I hate spotter plane. But he doesn't, so I'm waiting, hopefully. Do I wait? I hope. I'm not sure, but yeah, he's committing himself. He wants to approach me. Because he realized they need a cap. Well, all good and fine. So I hope for some nice broadsides, but he's not as kind. So see, he's stopping and changes speed. So this is practically how you can do it. I mean, you can also go bow in. He needs to block the cap. That's the main issue, and for that you should go bow in and maybe just use his front guns. Okay, let's go to the last topic. I mean, since the second wasn't showed this time. Succeed by outlasting and killing. This is probably not the best example for it, but you get the point. I can tell you I'm going down here, and there's nothing I can do about it. But I have these guys in my pocket who can kill probably the Hindenburg or one of these guys. Hindenburg lucky enough to eat no torp again. Yeah, I use damage con as a last resort. And that's my last volley out. And I hope I can damage him a bit more. And yeah, he speeded up. He's doing a good job in what he's doing. But he will go down to the Des Moines here, and there's nothing that can prevent it. And of course, it's going to be a close game, but still. So that's practically it. Outlasting the enemy by killing them, or tank more than the enemy. I used all my 5 heals. I have only 1.899 or 1.9 potential. That's just because I had ate so much HE damage and no Minotaur or something on the enemy team. And that's why we won in the end. Yeah, that's practically it. I hope you understand the points I was making, and I'm of course glad if you have to add, if you want to add something, or if you have something to criticize. I'm always fine with that. I don't say that I covered all the points, but I think the basic stuff I did, and yeah, I think that should be an okay-ish video, so to say. Alright. Thanks guys for watching. See you next time. Bye bye. Your Aito.